celebrate this Eucharist, the Word of God came to us in two readings. Just a small reflection on these two readings. First, we see St. Paul writing to Timothy, his companion, and together they are becoming conscious, or he is calling for consciousness that we are apostles. We are chosen and we are sent. Vocation is first of all a conversion. Conversion from the way of life in the world to conversion to the gospel, conversion to Jesus. And that is what St. Paul says. And this is really a fundamental thing in our life. Not to become Our aim is not to become only a priest, but we become the gospel of Jesus to everyone. In the second reading, what strikes us most is that blind cannot lead the blind. If you want to be leader, then we have to be enlightened and vision, have a new insight, and that is what the gospel reading today is calling for us. Holy Father Francis, right from the beginning of his ministry, one very important emphasis that he has been given, and I think it is the core message for all of us, for the whole church, and even for the whole world. Some people say it's very radical. Some people say it's non-traditional, it's progressive. But what he is saying is the gospel of Jesus. He is living the gospel. And that living of the gospel is the joy, gaudium, evangelii. That gospel is our joy. I can see from my own vocation, and I can see presently what my vocation should be and what has God done in this time. It's a transition, it's a transformation to the mind and heart of Jesus, and that is the conversion. And our formation is that I just, you know, just be open. God works. God loves you. God has chosen you. And He wants to, wants you to be a light of the gospel and joy of the gospel. I just share a few things. I don't want to be too long, but at the same time, taking this opportunity to share. I never went to the seminary, Bible seminary, before I entered my religious life at the age of 17 only. And when I was in the parish, the whole community was my seminary. The parish priest was my rector. Boy in the parish, in my journey, in my high school days, every month he was meeting me. One moment I saw a priest who was so close to me, priest who carried my wounds in the leg three times. He washed the wounds himself in his room, actually. That brought me very close to the life of a priest. And Holy Father says, you must be close to people. The more you be close to more, the people will see their vocation and we will be enriched in our own vocation and ministry. Be close to the people. I feel like, you know, the way we live in the seminary and the priest, we must touch. Touch the life of the youth. When I reflect on my own vocation and fathers who have here, the same story, some people have touched, God has touched. And this touch is very important in this heavenly time. Jesus is love. For me, it is now very important. It's not the ministry, it's not the function, it's not to be another group in the church. It's not to be ministers who are alienated from the people, but together with the people. I felt as bishop, first responsibility is to minister families. Why? Because I consider I'm a pastor, I've been a pastor as a priest 18 years, as bishop 31 years. But my question was, what is that? Who pastored me? And first, they are the pastors of the domestic church. Church lives at home. So, and that should be, when you are in the formation, that should be your aim. You know the situation of families now in the society. Unless we touch, unless we be close to the families, first of all, we'll not touch people, we'll not have vocations. shed their tears when I was close to them and listened to them and thought about things what God does. So, my dear brothers and sisters, this is my sharing to you this short reflection. Bangladesh, we are only 400,000 Catholics, 400,000 in the midst of 170 million people. Most of the others are Muslims. We are a little flock, a tiny community, but we are proud in the sense God uses this tiny community to, like yeast, to grow, like a salt, to give taste to the society. We are salt of the earth, yeast of the society, small lamb. And thank God, I thank together with you that every year now, from 15 to 24, new priests in Bangladesh ordain. This is the national seminary that we have. We have about 120 seminarians who are studying at the major seminary level in the Sanskrit, philosophy, and theology. And every year, as I said, their diocese is small, diocese, 30,000 people, 50,000, 60,000 people. But we get ordinations about on average about 20 every year. Sisters are there, seminarians at the minor seminary level, about probably more than 300. So, this is the story in the church of seminary members. We are universal. Whatever happens in one corner of the world, is happening in the church. And you share that. And we share that too, together with you. That's the mind of you, the motive, and the goal.